Hello, I'm Dr. Aizaz from MedicoVisual.com, and in today's video, we will have a 3D tour of fully mature placenta. So welcome to this visual lecture. So let's suppose that here we have a pregnant uterus, and let's cut a section of this uterus from here. Let's cut it here and let's remove this part, and this will be the structure that we will see. And as you can see that here is our beautiful unborn baby. I mean, not baby, it is the fetus at this stage. And as you can see that it is completely covered, it is completely surrounded and well protected by this amnion or amniotic membrane. And here is the amniotic cavity. Now the thing to understand here is that this amniotic cavity, it is not an empty cavity. It is actually filled with a fluid. A special type of fluid is there in this amniotic cavity, and this is called amniotic fluid. So what is the function of amniotic fluid? It basically acts as a shock absorber. This is the main function, that it acts as a shock absorber. Other than that, there are certain other functions as well. We will not go into details in this lecture. One of the important function is that it helps the baby to easily move inside the this amniotic cavity. And as you can see that baby is developing within this amniotic cavity at this stage. Now, if we cut a section, if we cut this amnion from here, then what we will see. So let's cut the amnion. So here we have cut the amnion, and here you can see that again this is the baby. This baby, it is completely wrapped around with another layer of amnion, and then this amnion, it continues with the umbilical cord. Here you can see that here is the umbilical cord, and here it continues with the umbilical cord. Basically, it is also you can say it is also surrounding the amniotic cord as well, and while doing so, it is also protecting the umbilical cord. And here is the placenta, and again it is also covering the placenta. So here is this amnion. If we remove this, we can see that it is also covering the placenta. So, and by the way, what is the location of placenta? The normal location of placenta is that upper part of side of uterus, right or left side, or in the upper part of uterus, posterior wall or interior wall. So normal position is that it is implanted at the upper part of uterus, and which side, right or left side, or forward or backward, I mean interior or posterior. All these are the normal positions of placenta. If the placenta is low lying, that is an abnormal condition. Here the placenta can be low lying. And another important thing is that sometime the placenta, it can be at this near the cervical opening. So sometimes the placenta can be here as well. So here near the cervical opening, if the placenta is implanted near the cervical opening, that is a dangerous situation actually. It is a dangerous situation because it can lead to bleeding during the late pregnancy, and in such situation, the normal delivery will be almost impossible. In these cases, we will need to do the cesarean section. So this condition in which the placenta, it is very near or almost over the cervical opening, it is called placenta previa. So it is an abnormal location or abnormal site of implantation of placenta. Now let's see the structure of an isolated placenta only. So here is the structure of placenta, and here is the fetal part, and here is the maternal part. This maternal part, as you must be knowing, that it is made up of decidua basalis, and it is made up of chorionic frondosum. And here is the cut section of amnion. That let's suppose we have cut the amnion from here. And as you know that this amnion, it is also covering, it is also surrounding the umbilical cord. And here are the chorionic blood vessels. And here there are two umbilical arteries and one umbilical vein. Please note that umbilical arteries are denoted by blue color because they contain less oxygenated blood. And similarly, the umbilical vein is denoted by red color because interestingly, it contains highly oxygenated blood. So here is the structure of placenta. And now let's cut a section of this placenta from here. So here is the cut section of placenta, and here what are the structures? Here these are the tertiary villi here, and these are the placental septa. So these are the placental septa, and this part, this it consists of the cytotrophoblast cells, and it is called cytotrophoblastic shell. These placental septa, they divide the placenta into 15 to 25 incomplete divisions called cotyledons. Now how this placenta works, that these umbilical arteries, they bring the less oxygenated blood into these chorionic villi. These are basically branched tertiary villi, and then the fluid will flow into these cotyledons, and then the exchange of material will occur between the maternal and fetal blood. So this was the 3D tour of placenta. Thank you so much for watching this video.